Then let us worship Christ the Lord, who for our sake endured temptation and suffering.
Come, let us worship Christ the Lord, who for our sake endured temptation and suffering.
Come, let us sing to the Lord, and shout with joy to the rock who saves us. Let us approach him with praise and thanksgiving, and sing joyful songs to the Lord.
Come, let us worship Christ the Lord, who for our sake endured temptation and suffering.
The Lord is God, the mighty God, the great King over all the gods. He holds in his hands the depths of the earth and the highest mountains as well. He made a sea that belongs to him, the dry land too, for it was formed by his hands.
In the beginning, is now, and will be forever. With your strong arm, lead us to freedom, as you mightily delivered our forefathers. Since you are the King who knows the secrets of our hearts, fill them with the light of truth.
Suffering humility, he came down from heaven to earth. clothed himself in that humanity in the Virgin's womb, and was born a man. Having then a body capable of suffering, he took the pain of fallen man upon himself. He triumphed over the diseases of soul and body that were its cause, and by his spirit, which was incapable of dying, he dealt man's destroyer, death, a fatal blow. He was led forth like a lamb. He was slaughtered like a sheep. He ransomed us from our servitude to the world, as he had summoned Israel from the land of Egypt. He freed us from our slavery to the devil, as he had freed Israel from the hand of Pharaoh. He sealed our souls with his own spirit, and the members of our body with his own blood. He is the one who covered death with shame and cast the devil into mourning, and Moses cast Pharaoh into mourning. He is the one who smote sin and robbed iniquity of offspring. He is the one who brought us out of slavery into freedom, out of darkness into light, out of death into life, out of tyranny into an eternal kingdom, who made us a new priesthood, a people chosen to be his own forever. He is the Passover that is our salvation. It is he who endured every kind of suffering in all those who foreshadowed him. In Abel he was slain, in Isaac bound, in Jacob exiled, in Joseph sold, in Moses exposed to die. He was sacrificed in the Passover lamb, persecuted in David, dishonored in the prophets. It is he who was made man of the Virgin, he who was hung on the tree. It is he who was buried in the earth, raised from the dead, and taken up to the heights of the heaven. He is the mute lamb, the slain lamb, the lamb born of Mary, the fair one. He was seized from the flock, dragged off to be slaughtered, sacrificed in the evening, and buried at night. On the tree, no bone of his was broken. In the earth, his body knew no decay. He is the one who rose from the dead, and who raised man from the depths of the tomb.
Everyone has sinned, and it's the crime of God's glory. We are justified through the free gifts of His grace, and through the redemption of Christ Jesus.
Really?
God, eternal shepherd, you so tend the vineyard you planted that now it extends its branches even to the farthest coast. Look down on your church and come to us. Help us remain in your Son as branches on the vine that planted firmly in your love. We may testify before the whole world to your great power working everywhere.
Look, O Lord, and see my suffering. Come quickly to my aid. The Lord's enemy.
His footprints shall their feet, and their subjection would last forever. But Israel would feed with finest meat, and fill them with honey from the rock.
God, open our mouths to proclaim your glory. Help us to leave sin behind and to rejoice in professing your name.
The Lord has fed us with the finest meat. He has filled us with honey from the rock.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. We see Jesus crowned with glory and honor because he suffered death, that through God's gracious will he might face death for the sake of all men. Indeed, it was fitting that when bringing many sons to glory God, for whom and through whom all things exist, should make their leader in the work of salvation perfect through suffering. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
By your own blood, Lord, you brought us back to God.
Thank you.
The Father anointed Christ to the Holy Spirit to proclaim forgiveness to those in bondage. Let us humbly call upon the eternal priest.
For mercy on us.
You went up to Jerusalem to suffer and so enter into your glory. Bring your church to the Passover feast of heaven.
Lord, have mercy on us.
You were lifted high on the cross and pierced by the soldier's lance. Heal our wounds.
Lord, have mercy on us.
You made the cross the tree of life. Give its fruit to those reborn in baptism.
Lord, have mercy on us.
On the cross you forgave the repentant thief. Forgive us our sins.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Gathering our prayers and praises into one, let us now offer the prayer Christ Himself taught us. By the death of your Son, you have given us hope, born of faith. By his rising again, fulfill this hope in the perfect love of heaven, where he lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.